She said, he's the kind of kid we like to forget. I was like, oh, why? And she said, because we can't help him.
Oh.
Yeah.
They reclassified him as...
My husband Jay and I first heard from Tammy and Scott when we were in a pretty weird place ourselves. We felt like we were done building vans for other people. It just didn't bring us the fulfillment we thought it might. We closed our warehouse and said we'd only do another van build if it truly meant something.
Did your idea for traveling in a van start?
Well, let's go back.
Trigger my memory on that.
Think pink. Barbie? That's where I think it
when
came
I
from.
Was a young girl, I had a Barbie RV.
This is Caleb. He's the fourth of 11 of Scott and Tammy's kids, and this is currently his life. He spends most of his time in his bed, where he's cared for by his loving parents 24/7.
I'll feel better, right?
Taking care of him while also dealing with insurance has been anything but easy. But they make it work with a smile on their faces.
Oh, we're gonna get Caleb snoring in the back.
Yeah.
And despite doing everything they can to give Caleb the best possible life against all odds, they still can't help but dream of more for him and for themselves.
We want him to have the best of care, and we also don't want to be home all the time. So that's why we want to travel. That's why we went to the van.
Once we heard their story, we knew we had to help. We headed down to Florida to stay at our longtime followers, Jim and Jenny's house. While Caleb, Tammy, and Scott moved into the guest house, we got to work in building out the perfect van for Caleb and his parents. My husband Jay and I have been building out rigs for 4 years now, but we've never built anything like this.
That's the tolerance.
There were some challenges that we had no idea how we'd overcome.
No.
That did not sound good.
Oh no, that's really bad.
But we just had to get started.
First day of the van build.
Okay, not everything was a challenge. Things like demo, soundproofing, and insulation were pretty standard. But Caleb has specific needs, not wants. He has machines that he relies on to keep him alive.
This is the pulse oximeter, and this measures his breathing, how much oxygen is in his blood, and this is his heart rate. And then the suction, that's for when we're brushing his teeth and any other time we need to help clear his airway. And the BiPAP is to help him breathe when he's sleeping. One of them goes into the stomach, this one does, and this one goes into the intestines.
So the first challenge we had to deal with was making sure he'd have enough power to survive. That started by being extra meticulous in things like wiring to ensure they'd have all the outlets they would need.
So there'll be a light under here to illuminate just Caleb's bed on a switch.
It can be hard to find enough room on the roof of a van to power anyone's needs. Let alone Caleb's.
Nice.
Luckily, Jay found the perfect roof rack that will help solve that problem.
So with the Unaka roof rack, the reason we chose it is because it is the widest rack I found for a Ford Transit, which means we can fit a 200 watt solar panel going widthways of the van. Whereas other racks in the past have only been able to fit 175 watt panels widthwise. Comes with these cross members that have a little notch cut out so it can fit around the AC unit, and there's another one made specifically for the max fan, so again you don't lose that inch and a half space.
This family's gonna have a nice security system. Whoa, just spoke to me. With this van, although in order to rob this family you'd have to be a real piece of
so I'm thinking this one's gonna go here like that. How does that look?
I think it would be nice if it was like
Yeah.
Things on the build site are going well. We got the security system installed and the laminate floor on without too much struggle. Now that we're out of the warehouse, we're dealing with more than just the struggles that come with van building, though. We're dealing with Florida's unpredictable weather, and that was definitely a struggle from the very beginning.
The storms are brewing. We're supposed to be in sunny Florida, trying to race with weather and get things done when it's not raining, but it's been raining quite a bit.
Do the warm dance.
This was something we'd just have to deal with.
Oh, dears.
Rain?
We also reminded ourselves any struggle we were facing was nothing compared to what Caleb and his parents have faced nearly every day for the last 29 years.
So take me back to Caleb's childhood. What was he like, and what was that like for you guys?
Didn't know there was anything wrong when he was born.
Not at first.
Right. And then about 7 or 8 weeks old, we had an upper GI that diagnosed a mid-gut malrotation. So he had surgery to repair that at 11 weeks old. And at 18 weeks old, he had a major seizure, and then he was in the hospital for 8 days.
Despite seeing countless specialists and doctors, they've never been able to discover a cause or syndrome.
Speech therapy, vision therapy, physical therapy.
Even with more than half a dozen surgeries and years of early intervention, Caleb has never been able to do more than a newborn. According to doctors, he also isn't like any other 29-year-old in the world.
He was an enigma.
And why do they call him the enigma?
Because they don't know.
They don't know.
The doctors haven't been able to figure anything out.
Tammy and Scott have spent 29 years without many answers.
About to put up some walls. This is when the real transformation starts.
Honestly, I guess in sharing their story, part of me does hope that they might be able to get some of the answers they're looking for. Life can be filled with many unknowns. You can let those unknowns paralyze you and make you bitter. Or you can do what Scott and Tammy have done and try to make the most of whatever life has thrown at you. Oof. The only thing I know for certain right now is that we are going to build them the best van we can. When you're building for people like Tammy, Caleb, and Scott, it ignites something inside you. You want to give them your best. You want every single detail to be more than perfect. You just want them to be able to enjoy it without ever having to worry about anything. This meant taking extra time and care in everything we did. Pretty much everything in this van will be bolted down by these tracks. These tracks have a few different benefits. The first being everything will be super secure. But they also come in handy at the end of this build. More on that later, though. Things are going pretty smoothly so far, for the most part.
Stay there!
But we knew we had a Goliath to tackle, the bed.
So the whole premise of the van kind of revolves around this bed.
Tammy first showed us her design for the bed, which she made out of Cheerios. The bed would have to be able to slide out to transport Caleb onto it. It would also have to be able to tilt slightly upwards to position Caleb comfortably. The first thing we knew for sure was that this bed would have to be strong.
Welcome to the world of 80-20. It's not like wood, you can't just...
Can't bend it, baby.
80-20 isn't his favorite thing in the world to work with, but we knew it was the only thing that would be strong enough for what Caleb needed.
Solid, look at that.
See how it looks.
See, that's why you test
it.
Oh, yeah.
You're going to have to notch up and down.
Oh,
cut it. Even though he doesn't enjoy working with it, the 80-20 was actually the easiest part of building the bed.
We've test fit the main skeleton, but now for the important part, to see if the stretcher... Have we even spoke about the stretcher yet?
I don't really think so.
The stretcher is what will transport Caleb to and from the van. After using different devices to get him on and off the stretcher,
hope it works.
They will need to store the stretcher under the bed. We were working with legit millimeters to try to make this thing fit.
Like a glove.
Even though we got the stretcher to fit, there were still so many unknowns.
The fridge has to have enough space to be pulled out.
Oh, and it's a chest fridge too.
And how deep can we make these kitchen cabinets? I won't know that until I make the slide out piece of the bed.
That's one side done.
Now I'm going to build the drawers and the cubbies for the bed platform.
Storage was another big challenge. We needed storage everywhere and anywhere for all of Caleb's medical supplies. And that started with the bed. There'd be storage on either side as well as four large drawers.
Another first for Jay is working with actuators.
A lot of thought has gone into this. Every quarter inch. And this will get screwed into the lid and it'll go. Ready?
Yeah. Moment of truth.
Oh. That didn't sound good.
No.
Nice. That did not sound good.
What the heck?
That's not good. That's not good, guys.
Luckily, the actuator's not working was a quick fix. Just cut off the excess wood it was getting stuck on. But that was the least of our worries. After solving one problem, it feels like another problem would arise. We then needed to stabilize it. So we stared at it for a while until coming up with a solution to reposition the actuator.
Stop.
Oh god, I'm scared.
Then when testing it out, we ran into another problem.
Oh, stop.
Yeah?
Like your bum's here, so it's just bending. Like you were staying there, but it was pushing this. The piece of wood itself isn't strong enough.
Could you put metal on it?
We honestly didn't know how to fix it. It was a lot, but we knew this bed was going to change Caleb's life. We knew we had to find a way to make it work.
In our house, he's got a nice room and it's fixed up really nice. It's got everything that he needs, but he has one window. And he looks out the same window every day.
Mm-hmm.
And that's his view, right? Or the ceiling. He looks at the ceiling or he looks out the window. And that's pretty much his whole experience, right? We try to do things to, like we built a birdhouse outside, you know, and we planted some flowers so that he can see different things. Right? But this is gonna open up a whole new world for him.
It's amazing what you can accomplish when you're building for something so much bigger than yourself.
I'll test it. Sit on it.
Okay.
Yes! Now it's not flexing.
I don't want to get too much into the technicalities of the bed and build itself. For those interested in more of the build aspect of this van, we've actually started a second YouTube channel called Kels and Jay Builds. We'll go into more detail about all that there.
Just a matter of days until this build's done, right, Jay?
Yeah.
The next 2 months were filled with lots of work, but I'd say even more laughter.
Can I see your tickets?
These are backstage passes.
It felt like as the build got closer and closer to being done, we also got closer to everyone around us.
There are cabinets in there, right?
Yeah.
Wow, you blink and you miss a bunch around here.
We also got to know Caleb really well.
All right, it's Valentine's Day. We're his Valentines.
We got Caleb something.
Aww.
I brought you a gift.
Does that mean he's excited?
We sort of forced our love for cats onto him, but I don't think he minded. Little by little, day by day, we were getting closer and closer to their dream becoming a reality. But it still wasn't completely smooth sailing. Where's the fun in that? Some of the challenges we faced throughout those 2 months were definitely challenges we created for ourselves. We encouraged Scott and Tammy to make changes if they felt it was necessary, because we wanted them to have the perfect van. About 6 weeks in, they realized they'd need a bigger water tank than the 22-gallon tank originally planned for.
Shit. Oh no, that's really bad.
We can't jam it in there?
Okay, I'm standing right
then. Jim's getting nervous.
We'd have to remove the kitchen cabinet to make this new 35-gallon tank fit. But remember those tracks I told you about earlier? This is where they really come in handy.
It's removable on this track.
Exactly. The key is removable.
In the past, removing these cabinets to fit the new tank would have been a pain. And it still was a little bit of a struggle, but the tracks definitely made it a much simpler process.
There we go, right? That might be it.
That's it. That's just how this build seemed to go, though. Sure, we faced challenge after challenge.
Oh my.
That is not set.
Making it work.
Who needs a workshop, eh?
But the energy around us seemed to make those challenges disappear.
Nice.
They felt simple and easier to work through.
Look at that. Look, look, give me this. That's the tolerance we were working with.
Yeah, that's great.
The bed from the countertop. Wow. Yeah.
As we continued on with the build, we were definitely certain to make sure all of Caleb's needs were met. Regulating his body temperature and being able to cool him down or warm him up is extremely important. Webasto was another company who stepped up big time for this family when they heard their story. They sent their top-of-the-line heater. This unit will provide a lot of flexibility and will perform at high altitudes if they choose to venture off somewhere, leaving them with one less thing to worry about. Scott and Tammy were so focused on having Caleb's needs met that they almost totally forgot about their own. They always put everything else above themselves. So when it came to toilets, they originally wanted to put in just a simple jar. After showing them all the different options, which Jim somehow had.
So you're talking about urine and poop?
No.
No?
What the heck is that?
I'm glad we were able to convince them to treat themselves to a real composting toilet.
Yeah, so it has its own diverter built into it.
Having lived van life, we know certain things are worth investing in. This van really felt like it was at the end for a while.
I know, I've said this probably like 20 times now.
We're coming into the end of the build.
It's actually the end of the build.
Like, what was that?
And I guess that's just because we really wanted to make sure we got every single detail right. Months flew by just like that, and before we knew it, the van was done. Now all that was left was for them to move in.
It's move-in day for Caleb!
Yeah.
Is he still gonna let you guys live with him, or?
He's shaking his head. No. He said no.
Caleb, we're outside.
There have been a lot of question marks for Caleb and his parents his entire life. But there are a few things that I know for certain. The love his parents have for him, being at the forefront of that.
They really thought that he would not live to be more than about 10 years old. And he's 29 now.
Got plenty of room over here.
Caleb, you're in the van.
Yay.
You're in the van, buddy.
Okay, that's it. Now go forward.
He Caleb, you are in the van.
We're on it.
And repeat. Ready? Going on your back, Caleb. Wow.
Look at you, buddy. Okay, hold on. His head is good.
They never gave up on him or their dream. And they now have a van that will take him places his body can't.
We have become and this is our new home.
Yeah.
And mine.
Please don't disappear. It's not what you think it's gonna be like, but nothing ever is. Caleb will enjoy the fact that we're enjoying life too, more so, and just I think he can tend to maybe sense.
Yeah, I hope so.
Yeah. You know, and I always would say, I think he knows more than we give him credit for.
Yeah.
This is what we've been after for a long, long time.
Oh,
yeah. Yeah. Oh. You like it? You hear the water?
Like that, Caleb?
Isn't that awesome?
Gosh.
You like it? And I don't really want to dwell on the hard times, I guess. I just want to think about all the fun, you know.
The future.
The future and the fun we're going to have. Yeah. And just enjoy, you know, because we've been busy since we were married.
We've dreamed about this for a long time.
Yeah.
We're really looking forward to it.
Yeah. Yeah.